How was that? So do you believe that I just saw that product commercial kind of video that you just saw now in this room at my home with my Canon 700D DSLR? So yes guys, it's just true. I just shot this video with a lot of limitations and successfully I was able to bring out a pretty good output. So in this video, we are going to see how I made that ad commercial kind of video, a complete shot breakdown and editing breakdown of that video. So without wasting any time, let's get into the video. So yes guys, let's start with the limitations I have before starting this video. So my camera is Canon 700D, which is kind of a basic camera, and you don't have 120 fps, that is you cannot slow down your video too much. I just have 60 fps max in this camera, and that is also not full HD, so I would have to compromise on the quality a little bit. This is the first limitation I had, and the second limitation is lights. Lights are the ones that decide the quality of your videos. So I don't have any high quality or video lights like Godox or Nanlite, etc. I just have an LED light. So this is the light I'm just using here also. I'll just show you that. So this is the 200 volt LED light I have been using for all my videos, YouTube videos, and also for this ad commercial kind of video. So yes, so what is the limitation we have while using these kind of lights? So these kind of lights do not like cope up with the 180 degree shutter rule. So while filming something, it's necessary that you follow 180 degree shutter rule the max as possible to maintain the good amount of motion blur in your videos. And also if you want to slow down your videos, you need to follow that 180 degree shutter rule. So if you don't know what is that, check out, I have made a separate video on that. So according to 180 degree shutter rule, if your FPS is 30 FPS, your shutter speed should be twice of that. So now I'm shooting this video at 30 FPS and my shutter speed should be at 1/60 of a second, but I have kept at 1/100th of a second because in 1/60 I will have light flickering. I'll just show you that directly live. So I'll just reduce the shutter to 1/60. Yeah. So this is 1/60th of a second. I'm shooting at 30 FPS and you will have this kind of light flickering. So that's one worst thing while shooting with these kind of cheap lights. It's actually 800 something. I bought it from Amazon. So yeah. So in order to avoid this kind of flickering, I must have to increase the shutter speed to 100. And only then I will have this flickering stopped. While doing these kind of adjustments, I cannot have a clear motion blur while slowing down my videos, and hence that is the second limitation that I have. So now I'll just adjust back to normal. So yes guys, these are the two limitations that I have, and yet I was able to bring out a pretty good output from this setup. So I am damn sure you can also do the same if you have a good LED light and a basic camera. So now without wasting any time, let's break down the shots and also look into the editing process. So guys, first let's check all the shots that I have took to make this video. So we have actually three stop motions. So what is a stop motion? If you don't know about stop motion, I have already made a stop motion of my camera back. That will be so interesting. So this is kind of photos arranged together to form a video. So that is called a stop motion. So there are three stop motions in this video in the first 9 seconds. And we have 8 other shots that I have clubbed together along with these stop motions and made this video. So let's first check the first stop motion, which is the first 2 seconds where the biscuits just move and come to an order in the center. So it's just kind of clicking images by moving the biscuits one by one. So just check the bits here. So for all the stop motions and almost every shots, we have used a blue chart as a background. So guys, this is our setup. I have used my tripod to have a top-down view of my camera. And this is the 200 watt light that I have already said in this video. This is how I took that video, just moving the biscuits one by one. I just had a vision of how I wanted my stop motion to be after the post-processing. So accordingly, I just captured these images one by one. I did not use the shutter button of the camera to click these images, as it may cause some shakes or change of frames between the images. Like one image could be in one frame and there may be a little bit of frame change in the second image. To avoid that, I have just used my touch shutter. That is, I have just turned my touch shutter off my camera and I just touched the screen whenever I wanted to take an image. And that's how I avoided any shakes or change of frame. So this is one tip that you can have in mind while you take stop motions to maintain the same frame throughout the video. So by just following the same process, I have made all the three stop motions. One top-down view stop motion and two state frame stop motions. So guys, I have shot all the images in raw format so that I can just work a lot more in post-processing, because too much of post-processing in a JPEG file would result in loss of quality. So to maintain quality, I have captured the images in raw format. Now moving on to the shots, the first shot is like there are biscuits arranged in the frame and you have two biscuits rolling in between. Actually, these arranged biscuits are stop motion videos and these rolling biscuits are actual videos. So how did I just combine them both? That we will see in the editing part. So that was the first shot I took. The second shot is milk being poured in a glass. So for that, I just used a green screen that I had at my home. So green screen is something like a green color cloth. So if you shoot with it as a background, in post-processing you can just replace that green area with some other background. So that's how I made this video. I have shot that milk being poured in a glass in a green screen background and I just replaced it with a blue background. So that was the second shot we took. So the third shot is kind of a similar shot where I just dropped a biscuit into the glass of milk and the milk splashed out. So I shot at 60 FPS. Yes, we cannot maintain that good motion blur, but we had got a good decent output. Now moving on to the fourth shot, which is just like a group of biscuits rolling into the frame. So this is also just shot in a green screen. I have just kept a green background and had some 5 biscuits together in my hand. I just rolled it into the frame and I just slowed it a little bit and replaced the background. That's what I have did in this shot. So the fifth shot was a big shot where I just wanted the biscuits to revolve automatically. So for that, what I did is I just took a broomstick. I just inserted that broomstick into the cream biscuit and I kept it ready. So in both the ends, I have two glasses. So while I just rotate, it doesn't fall off from the glass. So this is one well-known idea that many of us would have learned from Daniel Schiffner. So that's how I made this video. So the initial video was like this. I was just rotating the broomstick and the biscuits rotated. I will show you in the editing process how I removed everything and just had the biscuit at the center. So the next shot is also the same where the revolving is through the vertical axis. So for this, I just inserted the broom from the top of the biscuit and just rotated the broom so that I got a vertical axis rotation of the biscuit. So these two shots were made unique in post-processing that I will share that in the editing part. So now let's move to the last shot. So for this, I have just kept the biscuit packet at the center and arranged some biscuits nearby. I also have an empty glass. I will just roll a biscuit as I move my camera backwards. So this is also an inspired shot from a YouTube video. So for this, what I did is I asked my grandfather to just roll that biscuit and I slowly move the camera back. I just kept two points where the camera need to be in focus. So as I slowly move it back, at a point when the biscuit is in focus, I asked my grandfather to just roll that biscuit. So that's how you saw that biscuit rolling in between. And as I move a little backward, I asked him to just pour the milk into the glass. And yeah, that was a pretty good shot. So for panning this, you can just use a newspaper for just have a smooth pan. Or guys, one more thing that I would suggest you is like when you are out for some shooting and suddenly if you want to have a panning shot and you don't have a slider, you will think that I'm just gonna say use a cloth to have a smooth pan. So anyway, you're not going to carry your cloth everywhere you go, right? But you have your camera bag and your camera bag has this. So this is like the sponge kind of thing that just acts as a compartment in your camera bag. So this is very smooth. It can just slide on your surface. Just keep your camera at the top and slide it with the help of this cushion thing. It really works the best than any cloth camera hack or book camera hack. So if you have newspaper, go ahead with that or just use this. So that's it guys, we have now finished the shots. Now let's move to the editing process. So guys, before starting the editing breakdown, I will just confirm that we cannot explain every step of edit step by step. That would be a big video, so that's not possible. So first I will explain the basics of editing that is done on this video. So guys, I have followed three editing process for this entire video. I'll just explain those three in a short form so that you can understand the breakdown a little more easier. So the first one is background replacement with the help of green screen, and the second one is masking your required object. That is, masking is the process by which you can keep the required object alone in your frame and all the unwanted objects can be removed. And the third one is color correction and also some alignment methods that really helped me while making this video. So now let's get into the editing process. The first main thing is music, for which I have used the YouTube audio library. There are many collections here for free, copyright free music. So I have just selected the duration as less than 30 seconds and found this glitch music. So we are starting the video with a stop motion. So for stop motion, we have a lot of images. I have just color corrected them the same with the help of Lightroom. So this is the actual images and these are the color corrected images. Of the three editing techniques that helped me in this video, I'll start with background change. We have a sample video here, below which I have kept a blue color background that is hidden behind. So this is the background I have chosen. Now what I'm going to do is just go and search in the effect tab as ultra key and drag and drop the effect over this video. Now you will have the effect in the effects control panel. Just go to the color picker and just select the color that you want to replace. So you must have a single color as background in order to replace the background. So it's quite noisy. Just select aggressive from this drop down and yes, now we have replaced this background. So now you have understood how to replace a background if you have only one color in your background. Moving on to the masking part where we are going to remove unwanted objects. So in this video we have these glasses which are unwanted and also the stick. For that we just need to go to the opacity in the effects control. We have a circle or pen tool. You can just use them to draw lines around the biscuit. So I have just used a circle ellipse tool to just perfectly align that biscuit alone. So by just keyframing, I made sure that only the biscuit is visible. For clear understanding of masking, I'll just make a separate video. So that's it about masking. So moving on to the next process, which is alignment and color correction. For color correction, we have the Lumetri color panel, which you can use for color grading. For alignment, what I'm going to do is just create a new transparent video and go to the effects panel and add the grid effect. So once added in the FX control, you can just adjust the width of the grid, and this helped me a lot while making these stop motions, as I have done a lot of masking while making these stop motions. So now that we have understood the basic editing, let's see the editing breakdown of all the shots. So that's it for this video, guys. I hope you clearly knew how I made this ad commercial kind of video. So for the ones who are new here, I'm Cario from India. We talk photography, filmmaking and other social media stuffs that help creators like us. So if you're new here, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and click on the bell icon to get regularly notified whenever I make a video. So guys, if you want more such videos, do comment. I will make them all. So that's it for this video, guys. We'll meet you in another video. Until then, it's your Cario signing off.